We're going to the graveyard of the Megalodon. Somewhere you'd never expect. In a sleepy Bayside suburb lie the remains of the greatest predator the sea has ever known. Don't tell anyone, but here, in the heart of Bayside, is a secret museum of fossils. From bone-crunching sharks, like Cosmopolitotus plicatilus, to fossils of the largest flying bird that ever existed. The biggest problem we have is the most exciting fossils haven't been discovered yet. I'm Ben, a vertebrate paleontologist from Melbourne. I specialize in the extraction, preparation, and conservation of vertebrate fossils. And at first glance, you wouldn't think that we're standing on top of one of the most important fossil localities in all of Australia. This tooth belongs to a Totus megalodon, the largest shark that ever existed, more than half the length of a basketball court. It terrorized the ancient seas, munching down on the spines of baleen whales and whatever else was in these oceans. Let's go back in time to meet it. Just gonna calibrate my time machine here. I'll meet you there. The ocean was a radically different place 5.5 million years ago. The sea level was at least 20 meters higher than it is today. It was an ecosystem like no other, with the biggest sea monsters wrestling for dominance below the waves. And one of the undisputed tyrants of these ancient oceans was the megalodon. This shark was not a picky eater. It ate everything it could sink its teeth into, from lumbering sea turtles, agile bony fish, and even gentle and magnificent whales. The sight of a megalodon would have sent a wave of fear through the ocean. This is a fragment of small baleen whale jaw that was found in black rock. These indentations were made by a very hungry shark more than 5 million years ago, biting into the side of the jaw. You can only imagine how red the ocean would have been at that time. The megalodon had over 240 teeth in its mouth, and all were serrated like a steak knife. It was once thought that the great white shark were living descendants of the megalodon, but if you compare the serrations, you can see they're quite different. But why were these teeth so uniquely serrated? Ah. A straight blade gives you a cleaner, more precise cut. Excellent for cutting through soft flesh, but terrible when cutting through hard bone. The serrated blade is far more effective at sawing off meat. The megalodon bit with a sawing motion, enabling it to take huge chunks of flesh and even break whalebone. But how did the megalodon get so big in the first place? It's possible that part of this answer is due to competition. Was this an evolutionary war between baleen whales and the megalodon, the likes of which we do not see today? There are numerous biological advantages to a giant size. It makes it easier to subdue hapless prey like a small whale. There she blows! We should be very happy. The Megalodon went extinct at about 3.5 million years ago. It was due to a combination of factors, but by far the biggest contributor was the cold. The ice ages were only just beginning at about 3.5 million years ago, and this most likely changed many of the migration routes of the whales that the Megalodon feasted on. It's also possible that the rise of great white sharks and orcas played an important role in the Megalodon's demise. Ooh. The Megalodon could have been more than 16 meters in length and weighed more than 50 metric tons. That's the size of a modern humpback whale. Paleontologists are trying to find out how this animal hunted, but it's incredibly difficult to infer behavior from only bones and teeth. Many of these scientists have come to a similar conclusion. This shark was most likely an ambush predator, waiting at the bottom of the sea floor and hunting in the same way as great white sharks do today. Prehistoric Bayside was a special place. It wasn't just about the Megalodon, there were other equally gigantic predators that were swimming in these ancient oceans. Their fossils are only just being discovered. From this tooth, from a gigantic killer sperm whale that was discovered by citizen scientist Murray Orr, to this portion of wing bone from the largest flying bird that ever took to the sky, Pelagornis, found by citizen scientist Connor Brecken. We're right at the beginning of this exploratory period, and anyone can contribute to these discoveries. Welcome to the secret museum of Bayside. If you want to start your own journey into the world of paleontology, reach out to your nearest natural history museum or university and see if there's an opportunity to volunteer as a citizen scientist. Ben Francischelli is doing a lot of work to understand the prehistoric life of Bayside. You can contribute to his work by supporting his Patreon. The link is down in the description. This film was made possible by Leatherman Multitools. They produce knives and tools that are indispensable for modern day life. Take a look at the link in the description for the full range. The car was supplied by Brighton Land Rover. No other car embodies the spirit of adventure like this one. You can find this car in the full range down at Brighton Land Rover. I'll see you in the next video.